Well, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. For those of you that I don't know, my name is Greg Kaluski. I'm Assistant Superintendent at Queen Anne's County Public Schools, and I would like to officially welcome you to tonight's meet and greet with our new superintendent, Dr. Andrea Kane. Tonight is our second event. A few weeks ago, we held our first event, and next Monday, I believe that we'll hold our third event down on Kent Island. First of all, I'd like to recognize Mr. Sean Kenna, who's the principal here at Sudlersville Middle School, and Mrs. Carrie Mitten, who is the assistant principal, for welcoming us to Sudlersville Middle. Doesn't the school look great? And all of our custodial team have been doing a wonderful job across our schools getting it open and ready to start in just a few weeks. Next, I'd like to recognize two of our board members here that are with us this evening. One, Mrs. Annette DiMaggio, that represents this area, so please give her a round of applause. We welcome her. And next, I'd like to recognize this captain, Beverly Kelly, who's our other board member that's here this evening, so please give her a round of applause. And we appreciate our Board of Education and all of the support that they provide to all of us. We certainly can't do the work that we do without them. Tonight's event is an opportunity for you to engage with our new superintendent and to listen to her and some of her ideas and certainly some of her expectations as she has entered a little more than a month with us. And it is certainly my honor and my privilege to have the opportunity to work with her. Having the opportunity of working with Dr. Kane prior in Anne Arundel County Public Schools. So it's certainly a little bit of a homecoming for myself. And I look forward to her leadership and learning of all the great things that she's going to continue to build on here in Queen Anne's County Public Schools. At this time, I would like to introduce to you Ms. Jacqueline Wright, who's the assistant to the superintendent, who has a few remarks that she would like to make, and then we'll continue on with our program. Please join in a nice, warm welcome.
Thank you. Good evening. I first wanted to thank you and welcome you to this event this evening. And I wanted to thank everyone who participated in putting it on, Carrie and Sean. Thank you so much for hosting. I also would like to invite each and every one of you, if you have a concern, to write it on one of the cards if you don't get a chance to talk with Dr. Kane directly, and then we will call you and we'll get back to you on those things. At this time, we're going to have remarks, if they'd like to say anything, from our acting board president, Annette DiMaggio, and or our board member, Captain Kelly. Would you like to say anything? A few words for that?
Sure, I'll say something. These people here know me well enough. Right?
All right.
Well, y'all move fast.
Y'all know me, don't you?
Yeah. Right.
We couldn't hear you.
You couldn't hear me?
Well, I'd like to welcome the ones that have came tonight. We're looking forward to a wonderful school year. I just wanted to welcome everyone for coming and join the PTA. Please join the PTA. But thank you for coming out tonight.
Good evening. I too want to welcome you to come, and I also wanted to express my welcome to Dr. Kane. We as a board are real happy to have her come to work with our school system. We're really looking forward to new ideas to improve things in our system. So please don't hesitate to talk with her. You'll find she's very, very friendly, and but it's very responsive to what the questions are. So please be talking. We also wanted to thank our executive team for their support, for their leadership, and all the things to help everything go smoothly. And now, without further ado, we would like to introduce to you Dr. Kane, our new superintendent of Queen Anne's County Public Schools.
Good evening, and thank you so much to everyone who I've had a chance to speak with
and for the introduction and all of those things. I want to make sure I'm not fighting with this. So I really feel like I could use my cafeteria voice and not use the microphone. But I'm going to echo some of the thanks. I certainly want to thank our board members for coming and supporting the meet and greet tonight. They have supported me, and I appreciate the confidence that they have had in me and selected me to lead the school district. It has been a great honor and a privilege. I'd like to again acknowledge our leadership team. So we have members of our executive team here. So we have Mr. Mark Farley and Ms. Robin Langreff, who all of you already know. And of course, I'd like to thank, and Janet Pauls, who you also know quite well. Not sure if everybody knows Mr. Ronnie Wilson, who supports us in the mailroom and many other areas. He is a jack of all trades, I quickly learned. And certainly to Ms. Wright, who has been there to support me during my transition. She takes very, very good care of me, so thank you. But most importantly, or equally as important, I'd like to thank Mr. Paluski for the leadership that he has offered and that he has really dedicated a lot of time and energy to serving as interim superintendent over the course of last year. I do recognize that there have been many challenges, and he supported all of you, and he really led the team in working through those challenges. So to all of you, and certainly to Mr. Paluski, my right hand, I just say thank you. Thank you very much. You've made my transition here very, very smooth. It's always risky to start thanking people on an individual basis because you always leave someone out. But I certainly can't leave out Mr. Kenna for extending hospitality to us to allow us to use this facility. It has been a great pleasure. I have been so many places and had an opportunity to meet so many different people. You know, when superintendents begin their appointment in school districts, they usually start off with some type of a plan of action or a 90-day entry plan. And that entry plan generally has something to do with getting out and about in the community, learning about the school district, really just getting to know what's happening in the school district so that some type of a plan can be created from that to help to move a district forward. Well, my start has been very much the same. And I started my entry plan, my first 90 days, with a listening tour. And my listening tour has incorporated many different groups and individuals just sitting down to listen to the accolades that they offer the school district, the many accomplishments, and if there are any concerns. And I always ask about priorities. So if there are priorities that individuals or groups feel are important for me to know about, certain times they want to make sure that I continue something. They want to make sure that I'm not going to stop like Agricultural Awareness Day or something like that. And I'm certainly not here to flip this district upside down. And I'll say to you what I have said many times. There are many things that this district does extremely well. There are some things that this district does a good job with, some a mediocre job, and some things need improvement, as you well know. So I am here to help with all of those things, to continue those grand things that are happening, and where there is an opportunity for growth or improvement, I'm here to lead that as well. So it has been my great pleasure. Some of the places that I've been and some of the programs that I've had an opportunity to visit, of course, include the Sudlersville area. So Mr. Maggio gave me the backpack tour of Sudlersville and the surrounding communities, and very well known, as you very well know. And I had a chance to go through some places and visit the family center, and of course, the migrant program that we had going on over the summer, the Title I program, the Judy Center, lots of different places, and the Early Learning Center that will be opening soon at the old middle school. So a lot of different places I've had a chance to visit. But as far as the district has been concerned, I've had an opportunity to meet with the Chamber of Commerce, or at least Linda Friday, who leads that, the Bay Area Realtors certainly the sheriff's office, certainly the health department, Centerville Police Department, Centerville Rotary, had an opportunity to visit with our students who were doing some math work and leadership work over at Washington College over the summer. I've been to Chesapeake Community College and had an opportunity to speak with the leadership there to look at some things that will continue, some things that we will bring back to the forefront. There may have been some planning that Mr. Kalewski got started, and as the transition happened, we sort of put that to the side, but we're going to pick that up. One example would be the early learning, the early college academy with Chesapeake College. We certainly will get that going. And in speaking with some of the commissioners, there is opportunity for us to provide some transportation for students who may not normally have had an opportunity to go to the community college and take advantage of those college courses, which would serve as dual enrollment credits for them. So we're looking at some new opportunities, and we're looking at building out a CTE dual enrollment program in addition to the Early College Academy, so that our students can take advantage of that as well. So everybody's not college bound, but whether you are college bound or whether you're not college bound, you certainly are career bound. You're going to need to earn a living. And one of the pathways that we are going to be looking at and working with Chesapeake College is that CTE, that CTE pathway, so that we're ensuring that we're preparing our students for a workforce that is ready and ripe and waiting for them. So we'll do some of that work. Some of those ideas will certainly be new. So I've met with Commissioners Moran, Anderson, and Jack Wilson, had an opportunity to meet, of course, with the Retired Educators Association and some private citizens. I see we have Mr. Elsie Lawrence, who just joined us, so I've had an opportunity to meet with him, and Mary Walker, whom you probably, many of you know, and Mr. Broderick. Lots of folks that are doing outstanding work in promoting and building out some diversity awareness in our district and in our county. So it has been a wonderful, wonderful start to my first 90 days, and I am certainly looking forward to continuing that work. Part of my first 90 days also includes not only getting out into the community and understanding what the priorities are and listening to everyone, but also understanding opportunities where we can continue to build some structures for consistency in our practice. So we've been looking at and revising policies and creating regulations and procedures to accompany those policies so that everyone understands expectations and how to implement or how to carry out those expectations. So building some structures around practices and procedures has also been one of the focuses of the first 90 days for me, and we're off to a great start. One of the things that we'll be speaking with our leaders about this week, our administrators at the Leadership Institute, are the employee handbook and some expectations for performance and conduct for employees, as well as some expectations for students as far as discipline is concerned. So getting some structure around those types of things, all of that just helps to make us a better district so that we don't have one group or one school implementing what they believe to be a policy here, which might be different from another school. So bringing some consistency in our practices is another piece that we've been working on, and we have already gotten started with that. So as I have had a chance to get around, I begin to notice some commonalities, some things, and some common priorities that folks are asking me to look at. And of course, the tornado efforts for our folks on and our families on Kent Island, that is certainly a priority for us. And just so that you know, we are certainly building some supports for students around counseling efforts and of course, relief efforts that would support families with school supplies and things that they need, basic necessities. We're working on those kinds of things as well. The opioid crisis is something that I have heard about again and again from different groups of people. Had an opportunity to meet several times with Dr. Ciatola and the sheriff, as well as the Centerville Police Department.
So we're planning out some things that we'll be able to do to bring some awareness to that, because our role in that would certainly be prevention. So we're getting in front of some things that we can help families with and making sure the families have the resources that they need if they are impacted by that. Another area that has sort of stood apart is the area of communications and public relations. Folks want to make sure that they are getting accurate information in a timely fashion, and so we've got some ideas about how we might be able to enhance our efforts in that area, which certainly do include enhancing our website and our social media, getting a handle on those kinds of things. So that's another thing. And the last piece that I've noticed are some concerns around how we communicate budget and how we do budgeting. Of course, money's always on everybody's mind, and rightfully so, because it has a humongous impact on all of our schools. So we'll be looking at some ideas and some ways that we might be able to communicate our budget, the process, and all of those kinds of things with not only our employees, but the general public. So those are just some common themes that I've heard and I understand exist in my conversations with different groups of people. So we'll be addressing those kinds of things. So tonight, you know, I just wanted not to give long speeches and that kind of thing, but I wanted you to know how important it is that we are all on the same page with some things. I wanted you to know what my first few days have been, or few weeks have been like, what I've been doing, what's on the horizon, give you a little flavor for that, so that you understand, you know, as you get ready to send students back to school and as our teachers get ready to come back to work, where we're headed. So there will certainly be much more to come. This is just a little snippet of some things that have been done. But for you, I just would like for you to know that I have a commitment to ensuring equity. What's good for one group of students, if it is good, is certainly good for another group of students. And I am committed to ensuring that our employees are offering their very, very best. You know, sometimes I hear, and you well know this because of where we are right now, sometimes I hear things about North County maybe not getting the same attention that some other areas of the district get. And I would like for you to know that I am committed to ensuring equity in that area. So if regardless of a student's ethnicity, regardless of a student's gender or their family socioeconomic status, and certainly regardless of their zip code, we are going to be committed to giving our very, very best to every one of our students because we owe them that. That's what they need and that's what we owe them, and we will provide that for them. So I would like for you to know my commitment to you in that area. So, you know, one of my very favorite poets, Nikki Giovanni. Anybody know Nikki Giovanni? Heard of her? Okay, one of my favorite poets, she stated that we're better than we think, but not yet what we want to be. That may very well be the case for us, but we're headed in the right direction. There's another quote that I want to offer you. So one of my other favorites, Maya Angelou, one of the things she says is that hope and fear cannot reside in the same place. We must invite one to stay. And as for me, I invite hope to stay because that's the right thing for children. My focus is always on children first. Then our employees and everybody else falls, you know, sort of behind that. But that's what our number one priority is students. Always on the children. And those children belong to families. So it comes as a package. And so I'd like you to know my commitment to that. So I'm going to stop talking so that I can get around. Some of you I've had an opportunity to speak with already, and I'm going to make my way around to each one of the tables. And I want to thank you right now for coming out. I see some folks who came to the first meet and greet, and you're back again, and so I thank you for that. And we have one more, as was mentioned earlier today, this evening, at where are we going to be? At Stevensville on Monday the 21st, again at 6 o'clock. So thank you all for coming out. I'm open to any questions, and I'm going to come around to each table. So I hope that you grab a refreshment, something like that. And if you have some concerns or priorities, anything that you would like for me to attend to, there are cards on the tables. And if you want to jot that down, if you want us to get back to you personally, please leave contact information so that we know how to reach you. and then we're happy to do that. Okay. So again, thank you for coming out. I certainly do appreciate the warm welcome and the support, and I'm headed out to the tables, okay? Thank you.